And we are back now. TSM First Fanatic, welcome. And are you ready, I think is the question, because this has been a bumpy ride. We've played seven games so far in this eight-game day, and TSM and Fnatic are about to battle it out to see which team is going to be eliminated before the semi-finals.
Who would have thought?
Who would have thought, exactly. It does mean, though, that we are about to have one of, if not the most intense best of ones we have seen in a long time. The winner takes 100,000. Like, just to put this into perspective, one of these teams who had hopes or had a pretty massive chance of the finals is about to have to give that up. And so we've got a lot to talk about. We have an absolute load to talk about. And I think what we're going to do is just talk about each team individually. So we're going to start with Fnatic. What a squad. Team, arguably top one. I was about to say, arguably the first in the world. We've had a debate about that. Some people seeing TSM there as well. But starting with you, Natu. Let's kick in with Fnatic.
Yeah, I would say they're top one right now still. TSM is right below them. That's obvious. But just with the skills that they have, we're just all going to be repeating ourselves here so much. But all of Meister JW.
Yeah, that's the magic too.
Yeah.
I mean, you touched on JW.
The thing for me with those two is how they can have rounds where it goes down to like 30-second mark, nothing's really even happened, and then boom, all of a sudden those guys just make those random openings somewhere, and there's a favor for Fnatic, and they're going to utilize that.
Yeah, and you touch on JW. We've got a great example of just how aggressive, how has he managed to continue to have his playstyle, or at least close to his playstyle, even with this AWP change? Is he one of the few?
Actually, the weird thing is, when this AWP change came out, we actually had a break for like 3 weeks, and he didn't touch the game at all. So when he came back, he didn't really realize the AWP change actually was there. So he just kind of started just like, I don't feel it.
What changed?
Yeah, what changed?
That's crazy. I mean, it's probably the better way of doing it as opposed to seeing the change and then sitting there like, how can I do this? How do I adapt?
Just being angry for 2 weeks.
That's like the straight opposite of Kenny S.
Yeah. Who was sitting there like, right, time to improve. What have I got to kind of work with here? Talking more about Fnatic as well as a team, we know the map, and I think we're going to actually kind of structure it in a bit differently for this one. We have the veto done because, of course, they're playing in the other arena. It's going to be Overpass that we play on this one for a best of one, and that does raise the question, how on earth does Fnatic structure Overpass? Is this a good... I mean, I feel stupid saying, is this a good map for Fnatic? They have very few loopholes. But yeah, it's a good map for Fnatic.
Here's what's interesting to me about this matchup in general is just we've talked in this tournament about TSM. They have that defensive style of play. They're very good at taking fights. They're not going to be doing anything crazy. Fnatic, you know, JW makes those aggressive plays that you don't expect, and if they're successful, great, and if they're not, they fall back on the best player in the world, Olaf. They fall back on, you know, the fundamental genius in Krims, who can really equalize any kind of situation that JW's play, if it doesn't work, puts them in. But the thing is, TSM doesn't let them equalize the score. If they punish JW for getting aggressive, or anyone on Fnatic for getting aggressive, they're so good in the way they play together that they don't give that advantage back. They utilize it perfectly.
I mean, you saw an example just there with Krims going hyper-aggressive early. It's something that, I don't want to say Fnatic started, but it's something I started noticing a lot when they're on Overpass, where they charge like 3 CTs, push up, they try and get opening picks, presence towards Fountain, and then they disappear again. They're like just back on up. Like, it seems to be something that I've seen a lot of teams doing, actually.
That's the best way to play Overpass CT, in my opinion. Early aggression, that's going to make the attacking.
There's so many ways to do that.
Yeah, you can be really very versatile with that too. And that's going to slow your opponent's play down when you know that danger is up there. So I think that's one of the key factors, getting a pick or at least making your opponent's play slower.
I actually wanted to touch on your point with TSM being like this super solid once they get an entry. Actually, I think Fnatic is probably one of the best teams in the world being down a man and actually like grinding themselves back. So it's like an interesting matchup in that sense, which obviously has favored TSM
recently. Yeah, to touch on that aggression as well is, you know, for me, this map, what's crucial on this map is the bathroom area.
Yeah.
And even if you want to get aggressive downstairs, but a Terrace team on this map needs to be able to eliminate any kind of aggression in that bathroom, or at least, you know, trade efficiently. That can't be so costly to push the defense out of bathrooms. They need to be able to get onto that A-bomb site without sacrificing 2 or 3 players. Because once you get whittled down by any kind of bathroom aggression, you're in a lot of trouble in how you can play that map.
Yeah, and of course their opponents, TSM. Talk about them for a second, as the All-Stars of Fnatic have to have an opponent, and they're pretty damn close second. TSM, the team who I feel like we've seen so much from them in the past in these high-pressure scenarios. Like, they're one of those teams alongside Fnatic. It feels dumb to kind of say that, but these are the two teams who usually really handle their...
They're just fundamentally very, very solid on, like, they're a very fundamentally solid team. Like, that's it. Like, the way they, like, team play with their flashes, like, all of this stuff is, they're the best at that. I mean, Fnatic, they obviously, in my opinion, they have stronger individual plays, but they're not as effective as TSM on those fundamental, like, actually every time flashing for their teammates, getting picks and, like, clearing areas. And so it's...
This is showing TSM synergy. It's something that the point that wanted to be made, and I'll let you make that, Natu, that these are guys who basically like to flash each other in. They really work as a unit in contrast to some others.
Oh, yeah, definitely. And I think a lot of... I think Kerrigan coming into the team has really brought a lot of that with just... And he brought in a winning mentality. Kerrigan's won tournaments before, has a lot of history playing Counter-Strike. So I think other than that, only just becoming better tactically per se, I think just the general, I should say, feel and just how they approach situations is just much more decisive than before. Before they were just running into situations, not really entirely being sure what they were getting into. Now it seems like they always have a plan on what they're doing.
Yeah. And so in terms of recent form, Moses, is there a team that kind of stands out to you?
TSM?
Yeah.
Absolutely. We mentioned earlier when Andrew's at the desk that there's kind of some cracks showing in this Fnatic hive mind, as he calls it. And, TSM is just a team I just mentioned. One of the few teams who's been able to neutralize Fnatic not being able to equalize when they're a man down. I mean, they are the best team in the world at playing in a 4-on-5 or a 3-on-5 even, or 3-on-4. And TSM doesn't let them do that. And it's because once they have that man advantage, so fundamentally good at getting trades as they enter into bomb sites, they're not going to let Krims get two of those kills that we always see him get against every other team. Very decisive in how they take it, and they don't give these Fnatic players time, you know, to recover from one kill. They trade it off immediately. It's very, very well done from TSM.
Yeah, one of the best executes on sites in the
definitely
world.
Yeah,
and yeah, it's gonna be so interesting. I just want to see this.
I know, we are just chomping at the bit.
I mean, think about it. It's such a high pressure situation.
Yeah.
It's the best to one, loser goes home in this type of a tournament.
Yeah,
I mean, and it's Fnatic TSM.
This type of a tournament, as in the highest prize pool outside of a Valve major. That's like in CSGO history. That's like a big deal. And one of these teams is about to lose that chance.
I actually think that this is way worse playing this kind of match than like a semi-finals or maybe even a final at times. Like they want to save themselves from the embarrassment from being like the two best teams in the world getting knocked out last in the group stage of this of a big tournament.
They're going to be right there with Luminosity.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Interesting.
That's an interesting
fact. That's an odd feeling, yeah.
Wrap your head around that one for a second.
I think about that.
I mean, this is... I'm trying to think of when the last time either of these two teams has faced elimination in a best of one. For Fnatic, it's probably been years.
Probably has. Yeah, sorry. So
awkward silence.
That's the cricket.
I was trying to think.
I was hoping Devilwalk would know.
I was just double checking, as it is time for us to get on into game. I'm so ready for this one. We are not going to move a muscle. You shouldn't either, as it is my pleasure to introduce a casting combo I was talking about in Katowice as well. It's Pansy and Anders. It's Pandas.
Thank you so much, Alex, and well done remembering that glorious name that I think was given to us a long time ago, the early CS stuff. Was it Red Eye?
By a certain Mr. Red Eye, yeah,
oh,
I believe
Lordy.
So. He even threatened to come up with a suit and everything. It was quite scary, actually.
That was true. I'm glad that's not quite happened just yet. We had to put him across the Gfinity to make sure it didn't happen. But still, we're about to bring you a game that just, I never thought it'd be in this point. I never thought I'd see this matchup today. It was,
no.
There was no way looking at the groups this morning.
I've never been happier than I stopped betting skins because I would have lost so much. Today it's unreal, and I, you know,
it's been the apocalypse for skins today. Let's be honest here. Like,
a
how
lot
much
of people
have gone wrong.
A lot of people have become very poor, and a few people are very rich all of a sudden. Such is life. Look,
But still, what can you say on this game then? Because head to head, these two, you know, you'd normally take this into a best of five format. You'd go through the performance throughout the entire stage. Now you've got two, well, questionable performances. And what else can you say about them now? It's a best of one. We're seeing two of the best teams in the world. How much is there to say?
Historically speaking, TSM have got the better of Fnatic as of lately, but in a best of one game, I don't think you can easily just put, you know, a historical narrative on this and say, well, you know, because when you play best of three, best of five games, it's very, very different. The fact that we're playing Overpass makes me think that TSM have a little bit of an edge. I feel like Fnatic are a little bit more shaky on this map, but like I said before we got started, Lauren, I almost just want to say, look, it's whoever gets the best start here, because I feel like
you're playing that card.
Yeah, I have to play that card. You know, I hate sitting on the fence, but
I'll let you do it this time because there's no way we can even win. You make a prediction, you're basically betting one of the best two teams in the world is gone.
Yeah.
There's nothing more to be said. It's going to be a game of, as you said, who turns up the best at the start, who can continue that pace on, and you're assuming maybe TSM have something in mind. And we said it before, we were discussing this, we want to listen to those team comms as much as possible, because I know you speak to the TSM guys a fair amount. I know you can even understand, you know, a little bit of the Swedish coming out of Fnatic. So I want to see how these two are kind of coming into this as well, especially. That's the big thing for me, is mentally, how do you prepare for a game like this?
Yeah, it's really, really hard because you don't want to like overthink it too much either. I mean, it is a best of one game, and I think it's just like taking it one round at a time from the very get-go, trying to see if they can get their minds right here and just play the best game possible. I think the good start here is going to be vital, and it seems like it's a slow round from TSM. I was actually wondering if they were going to go for one of their fast plays, because they do have a couple towards the A side, but this time it's just going to be a little bit casual with Pronax right around the edge here, and he's going to be going for a fight early on. Takes a shot to the face, and Carrigan takes him out, but Olofmeister gets two in return before he drops, so still a fairly even trade. Probably still favoring TSM, and Crims up here is going to try and put down a grenade, but I don't think he'll be too successful. JW gets the kill before that's even necessary. Bomb Planter is going to get one right to the face as well, but he does take down Flusher, so it's a 2v2 still with the bomb down.
This is going to be a big moment. Can TSM hold back Fnatic? This is the question. JW starting to peer in. The bomb still ticking. Crims is looking for a chance here, but time is starting to wear out here. TSM are holding onto this device, just down by the pit. Zipnik's to find JW. It's all down to Crims. 1v2 for the first round to kick this one off. That good start may just have gone in towards TSM's favor.
Yeah, I mean, that looked like it could have gone either way. I actually thought that grenade from Crims up on the high ground was going to do a lot more damage. Instead, it did like 11, so I'm not really sure what happened there. Either way, pretty decent plant there for TSM. Not really sure about the after plant. I don't think they needed to fight as much as they did, but they felt confident and they managed to do it. Now, two scouts being picked up here by Fnatic, and the weaponry on TSM is not exactly great. They do have two AKs, but then two submachine guns as well. If one of those AKs dies to a scout, it's going to be real tricky.
Certainly will be. JW and Olof running those, no surprise really to the Fnatic side. And it looks like, once again, TSM looking towards B, making the play through mid. You've still got Dupree there. Cajun B just making his way in. He's actually got fairly close up to site. Checks for Pronax, gets him down. And it looks like they're getting a good footstep into the site until right then Flusher with the double. This guy with the CZ is insane.
Yeah, I can't believe he actually does that, because that was such a good start for TSM, and very low risk as well, putting only one person in. So if they do find a stack, then they only lose one guy with the Galil, and maybe they could deal with that. Bomb's going to go down once again here, but it's a 3v3. There is a kit on Olofmeister, and that could actually be important if they're going to try and go for the retake, which I reckon they will. Crim's going to be taking down Carrigan. Now it's up to Cajun and Device, and they don't have a lot of health here. They got to get this kit away from Olof, and preferably far away from the bomb side. That will really hamstring Fnatic here. Device running up from behind, making a lot of noise, but not going to be heard by Crims, and it's down to a 1v2 here, and he goes down. Olofmeister with a shot from the scout, and Fnatic, they win it right back here, and that kit making all the difference in the world, and that is going to be a huge round, obviously, for the Swedish team.
We wanted an explosive game. I think we just got one. This is exactly what we wanted to see. Let's actually tune into the... Should we go for the TSM side, see how it's going? See how it's going on their side of things.
Hello, over mid pro. Hello, over mid pro.
Yeah. Dark on your flash.
All right, so real simple. They're just going to try and essentially flash up from underground while they're running up above here. So really fast strat coming out here. Carrigan going to be in charge of the flashing. Not really too elaborate, but when you're playing with just pistols, I think it's a good idea to try and keep it simple. So there's the flash they were talking about as they come out of underground, and Crims pushing close here with the FAMAS. Actually going to go down to Cajun, so this speed here is catching Fnatic just a little bit off guard, and almost JW gone down. They've got to be careful here, Fnatic. They don't give too much away. TSM are a dangerous team with these pistols as well. Cajun taking another headshot with the Deagle, But the bomb is down, and Fnatic should be able to stabilize here.
100%. You've got what, Olaf on the site. You've got JW still on long, even though he's pretty low on 8 HP, and Pronax still in position. Cajun B gonna go hunting. He's still got the deagle. Got two so far. He's gonna have to make it three, and he does. That's massive. It's a 2v2. The bomb's still down, though. This is gonna be hard to break into.
Yeah, device spots. Jumping behind the box there, Olafmeister. Cajun going to pick up a scout there. Proax will take down device, so Cajun, 40 seconds here. It's going to have to be an ace, and he gets a headshot on Proax. Now it's a 1v1, and the pressure obviously going to have to be on Olaf here. Cajun sneaking up, deagle in hand. He has no idea what Olaf is. He must know he's in the bomb site, but there it is, the jumping shot from Olaf. He must have seen just a pixel, and that was enough, and they barely win the round, but a very, very expensive round, obviously, for the Swedish team here. And TSM, as a result and as a direct consequence here, they're going to force up no matter what here. I mean, I think they had the money, but even if they didn't, they would have bought anyway. When you do that much damage and you're so early in the half, you're going to be buying here. Yeah, they did have plenty of money as well.
And with something so simple at the start, you just see it flourish like that. When you've got players like Cajun B who can just go off, it's beautiful to see. But JW there, just going to be watching that cross a little. I'm not sure if he spotted anything. I don't think he did. I think they're going the further way around. But a very cautious, careful TSM now. They're taking their time here.
Absolutely, and I think that's a good enough idea. It's kind of hard going fast on this site. It used to be that people would be very comfortable rushing into the B-bomb site early on, but there's lots of ways to counter that now. And if you're going fast on A, you can run into all sorts of weird setups. So you can see that it's clearing out the long area here. Dupree will spot it out, and actually device in the background gets that shot on JW, and all he wanted to do was just jump and get a little bit of information. So that's actually quite cool. Very important early kill. 55 seconds left. They still got plenty of time to move around. The bomb is making its way back towards that B-bomb site now. And Cajun and Dupree probably just going to be in charge of making some noise up here before they rotate back down again. And we'll see how that's going to unfold.
I just want to see this round come to fruition now. You've got Pronax, I think, is the only player still dedicated towards B. The rest pushed up by Toilets. You've got Flusher kind of pretty passively at the moment, holding back. And we are starting to see TSM building in towards this plant, on towards that B-bomb site. Zipnix is carrying the bomb to hand, but here we go. There's Olaf fighting Cajun. There's Pronax. Finally, Kerrigan chimes in, and this is still all up in the air. Dupree with a fantastic opportunity. 2v2, though. This could go either way.
Bomb's still not down with 15 seconds, and they might actually not make it out of this round here, TSM. It's going to be really close now. Olafmeister sneaking up behind. He's going to get the spray down onto Kerrigan, and it's down to device here in a 1v2. And this is going to get really difficult. It's only just gone down, this bomb. He has to get the first kill and then try and hide for a while. He sprays and doesn't connect, and Crims takes him out from the side of the wall there. Very unfortunate. It seemed like he could have probably got that kill if he had committed to the spray, or maybe even done a better job just hiding. But he sort of went for an in-between kind of play, and that didn't work out. Huge round for Fnatic, and potentially a bit of a big giveaway for TSM as well here. I mean, the decision to go B, even if they lost the entries, they still should have done a better job here.
Yeah, clearly being a factor. Let's actually tune in towards the Fnatic side, see how they're feeling now. They've started to pick up rounds themselves. Let's see how it's going down.
Jag ska bara stå upp, jag gör det. Ja, bara stå upp snabbt.
Ja,
chilla
lite också bara.
Ja, jag
står
och lyssnar
och tar
ett skott
som backar. Jag lägger fan smoke där framme som tror att vi kör.
Jag backar.
De kör smoke, VC.
Yeah, so a bit of a smoke going on towards the toilet there, and just a call to play, keep playing it cool. Don't be too aggressive. Play it chill. Let them come. And it turns out that's actually a pretty decent call right now, as they're in a 4v3. They've got the first frag here onto Fnatic, but TSM are still looking too good, and there's going to be a touchdown. Oh, they just make it back. Otherwise, that would have really been two dead TSM members. But they are rotating back, and the bomb is all the way back in T spawn. So even if they had control of this A bomb site, they couldn't do anything with it yet. That's a bit unfortunate.
It certainly is. Now Dupree, he did have the 1v1 against Olaf just a second ago, but JW straight away getting over here. Crim's not far away either. But device is still in a curious spot, maybe just holding that rotate through mid, but Dupree still trying to battle this one out, and just on the corner there, you can see him with the x-ray, but sadly Dupree cannot. And Olaf will lock this one down and deny maybe that chance for this to work out, and we will be seeing device go down. Zipnix, the one with the Galil, looking for a little something here. 32 seconds. Flash comes through, the B comes out. Zipnix does actually tag up these guys pretty heavily. There's still a chance, but Flush is on the way behind. It's not going to be long before he's going to have pressure left, right, and center. 20 seconds. And Olaf and Crims still holding strong. Desperate to find an angle. He hears the orb rattle off. I don't think he's going to have time for this one, but no, he finds Olaf. And now 1v2, Zipnix has made this more possible.
can't believe it. It's actually kind of unreal that they haven't been able to group up on him. And now they've revealed themselves coming from behind. Yeah, he saw those shots, but he's not even going to look. This is so cool. Very, very calm play coming out here from the Danish player. He's going to spray a bit, walks back towards the bank, gets the spray, almost takes down Crims. That's so close. He's got no grenades, and they're going to try and flash and Molotov their way and try and zone him out. But is he going to be able to do it? He gets the first kill there. Now it's just up to Flush. He's got 13 health. He's going to walk in. Sipnix is praying. Oh, he gets the kill. God. Unreal. Quad kill. And Sipnix, look at that smile. Just a bit of a crack on one side of his face. A wintry smile.
He just played everything so perfectly. He spotted it was a fake. He saw the footsteps moving away as that Molotov came in. He didn't have to overpeek it. He baited out the shots. He got the information so perfectly done. And we're only into round six. This game is going to be incredible. Fnatic leading 3-2, but TSM showing us exactly what they have in store. And well, mind-blowing.
I mean, 99 times out of 100, if you're in a 3v1 like that and the guy has to put the bomb down, I'd say just wait for him to plant. When he's planting, move up, get closer so that even if he gets the bomb down, he'll lose the round. But Fnatic actually didn't make, I mean, they didn't make horrible mistakes that round. Sipnix just somehow managed to zone them out. I'm not sure how he got the first kill, that's the problem, but
yeah.
He seemed to play that one really patiently, and Fnatic weren't like being overly aggressive either, as far as I could tell. So obviously they were being too aggressive, but they weren't making like the classic mistake of just like trying to take the fight early on, because we're in a 1v3 anyway, we're gonna win it. TSM now are gonna fake A once again here. So putting up a couple of smokes as the bomb is making its way back. And Fnatic with a really big presence towards the restrooms area. And I was talking to Moses earlier, and he said, in his opinion, the restrooms part of the map is the most important. If you control that, you control so much of the map.
Well, you look at Virtus Pro, every single round, you'll have Pasha and Snacks push straight up. They don't mess around. They take control of it on that CT side, and they rarely give it up. You saw that kind of costing a good few teams their position in this event. But as you said, they have adapted round, and we know what Flusher can do with this CZ, but it's going to be a tough chance to put it to use. He has got a good couple of tags here. JW spots him out, and oh my god! Pronax and Flusher coming in. That nade could have just changed this round completely. They've got the AKs, but I don't think they can get any more of them.
Cajun, last man standing, and he's going to go down as well. What a round. That was a touchdown grenade. Kobe grenade, if you prefer. That was...
Kobe Bryant just turned up in game.
That was kind of ridiculous. That really rarely happens as well. If not for that, probably TSM get up onto the bomb side, and we're talking about an afterplant, and everything gets a lot worse here. Olaf Meister at 8-1-2. I mean, he has a creepy tendency to turn up in these games when it really matters, and he's playing extremely well at the moment. But obviously, Pronax getting that sick grenade in here. Krim's going to spot them and fall back. Going to put up a little bit of a grenade. An easy kill here. No armor and just pistols on the TSM side. And Fnatic are going to clean up here. Lots of wonderful eco frags coming in for Olaf.
I love padding out that score, you know what I mean?
Feels so
in case he needed it, you know what I mean? It's oh well, he doesn't need help in these situations.
Kills for a rainy day.
Yeah, just saving them up in his little bag of tricks. But 5-2 is the scoreline. We are seeing Fnatic starting to edge ahead here. But it does seem so close in these rounds.
Yeah.
I don't think we've seen a definitive leader yet. You know, of course, you can't always depend on Zipnix to pull off ridiculous rounds like he's done, or those nades to come out from Fnatic, but for some reason with these two teams, you seem to get these phenomenal moments time and time again.
Yeah, I mean, there's a growing history between them, so we're going to have to see here if TSM can turn it around, because they are playing on the terrorist side, and since the change to that A-bomb site, I actually do expect teams to get a lot more T-rounds here. I'd love to see TSM get up to 7, maybe even 8 rounds on the first half here, and that's not going so well at the moment. So we're gonna see. There is still the Mag 7 on GAW, which is not necessarily a downgrade. He's super good with that weapon. The problem is TSM have Device and Kerrigan on Tech 9s, and Dupree has an AK, but he only has 2 kills so far in the first 8 rounds, and we need him to do a lot better.
Certainly do, and I actually was trying to rack my brain thinking back to when I last saw TSM really on the T side on this map, and through the online phase of the season, we rarely got to see it because their CT side was so strong. You maybe had about 3 rounds maximum, but it's nice to see what they have in store here, and we're going to be having to see what they can bring. And it's a little bit of a mixed bag by, as said, with the Tech Nines in practice, but still, it is go time. We can see Kerrigan bursting on towards the site, not checking out for Flusher, who's just standing tall and doing the job and gets the double. However, the AK will at least fall into Device's hands, but he's got a lot of work with Cajun B now.
Yeah, Cajun picking up a kill, 30 seconds left, and if they try and get the bomb down here, they're going to get grenaded once again, so that's a big problem. Device now with a 1v3, and he's going to pick up the AK and I think try and see if he can make his escape. He will have been hurt already, I think JW at L-Bend there. Yeah, he heard him running back, so he's going to go look for him already. Wow, this is a big turnaround, and I think Kerrigan made a very tiny mistake getting to that bomb site because his teammates were up around that column in the middle from the other side, and yet he felt the need to check all around it, so maybe checking a bit too much. Let's try and listen into TSM and see what they have to say.
Kan vi prøve at tage en rundt igen? Kan vi tage en top med? Jeg tager to flashes med, okay?
Og så bare kom lige ud på dem, ja, i hovedet,
når de
videre.
Prøv her, jeg flasher lige over undergrunden, og så tonser I bare videre hækken, så siger jeg til, at anden flash kommer super langt mod hækken. Okay?
Alright, so once again, they're gonna flash over the hedges down there, and then the rush up through underground. So this is apparently just the sort of the TSM default eco round strat. See if they can do it. So they're gonna go on the second flash essentially, and there it is for Olaf Meister's in a pretty good position. He's got backup as well. Occasion still doing work with that Deagle, but it still looks really tricky here. JW's got the Tech 9 out. Gonna be taken down Sipnixon. Cajun and Kerrigan very low on health, so good damage being put out here, and the bomb plant is actually huge. It's going to go down, and that grenade will finish Kerrigan, but this is a big victory for TSM.
Yeah, fantastic stuff. We've seen how good this round can be. They're very simple yet aggressive play. Just seems to pay off very nicely. The round prior to this, when they had to pull it off, went quite to some similar fashion. However, Flusher will close down the round and get the defuse, but as said, highly successful considering what they invest towards.
Should we try and listen to TSM again and see what they can actually do with rifles? Yep. I really want to know.
Jeg har to flasher med, flasher fra lang. Jeg synes, jeg sætter dem mod langt ned undergrunden.
Alright, so one call is all we heard here, and that was a call to flash long, so that's what we call the picnic area. See if they can get a pick off there. They did that earlier. Device took down JW and actually spawned a win for them as well, so we'll see if they can get that working. But they got to take connector first, and Olafmeister's being very aggressive. This is cool stuff. Fnatic is trying to change their setup before TSM figure out a way to counter it, and well, Cajun countering both Crims and Olafmeister in connector. So now the whole TSM setup is essentially mute because they just had to, you know, Cajun get some pretty amazing entry frags, and you can't really even account for that. There's no strategy that involves this. This was just a good play from him individually.
Yeah, it reminds me when we were sat at the desk and it was Dupree listening to the in-game comms from CLG saying, God, they talk so much, these guys. There's so much noise. And you hear the comparison to TSM, who are very calm,
yeah,
very cool strategy calling, very just to the point, but still. Flusher and JW alive in this one. It's going to be extraordinarily hard for them to find anything in this, but let's see if they can achieve anything, take some guns away. JW's in a good spot, but I think Agent B may have heard him already, but it doesn't matter all the time because JW can do that, turns it around on its head, picks up Agent B. We still got Flusher on the A site. Kerrigan finds JW. Flusher now the last line of defense. It does get a fantastic shot towards Kerrigan, but it doesn't really matter. Device closes it down, and TSM get a well-needed round.
Yeah, monster entry from Cajun, almost the third kill. I think you're absolutely right. He did hear JW running up the stairwell then, so that's gonna, it's obviously gonna make that kind of flank very difficult. And maybe JW didn't need that kind of speed. The bomb wasn't down. He wasn't under any pressure to get in. So maybe a little bit too quick there on his feet. But 7-3. I think TSM need to win the next three rounds in a row, more or less, before we can start sort of calling this a comeback. Otherwise, Fnatic are still in a pretty good position right now, in my opinion.
It's quite worrying seeing TSM in this sort of state. It's very uncharacteristic of what we've seen thus far, from considering they are, you know, pretty much considered a top three, if not top one team in the world currently. We need to start seeing that. And that's a very good start there from Device, finding JW down on toward long. And this is just pretty dangerous.
Well, I mean, I have a lot riding on this, Lauren, because the question was asked earlier on the panel. They said, who's the best right now? Like, you know, right
currently,
today.
Yeah.
And I said, I think TSM, I think they're the better sort of team as a team, whereas I think Fnatic have a higher skill ceiling. I think TSM work to get together a lot better right now, but obviously Fnatic are really putting in the work right here. And again, if you lose this best of one, you're out of the tournament. That's it. You get to travel home on the very first day as well. Cajun going to be wrapping around, but he goes down, and Crims will also take down Kerrigan. So it's up to a 3v4 now, and the problem is there's only 35 seconds. They need to be so quick now on the Danish side. Going to fail the grenade, and bomb is being picked up here. Device goes down. Sipnix, the last man, 1v3, goes for the spray and does connect with Olaf, but he's also down to 28 health, and there's really no way out of this scenario. I can't see this working out. They're going to hear him before he even gets to the site, and Flusher, he's already smiling because he knows Sipnix is already dead. Wow. Okay, Crims is going to take the kill, but the result is very much the same here. 8-3, and a very bad situation for TSM.
I kind of want to hear the Fnatic side, see how they're kind of communicating in comparison. We heard TSM very calm, very stoic, very simplistic.
De har överlevt. De kan
inte. De fick ingen plan för oss.
12-3 nu, boys. 12-3 nu.
Det är ingen hjälp nu, alltså.
Jag kommer smoka UG och vara.
Bortsett jätte därför. Ja, de måste tjänat.
All right, trying to see if I can translate it in my head. Swedish is hard when they speak fast, I'm not kidding. So, I don't know.
But they're clearly talking more than TSM. You look through it, the CT side is discussing a hell of a lot more than the T side. I don't know if that's indicative of anything really, but clearly Fnatic know what they want, they know what they're doing. They're this far up, you know. I don't know how much they need to say at this point, because when you've got Olaf just going off on these 1v1s, make it a 1v2 he's just pulled off there on long, just locking it down, they make it look so simple. Yep, it's against TSM.
The communication we've heard from Fnatic so far has mainly been trying to guess what TSM might do. So they're playing a very sort of, like, instead of just having like a default setup where they say, well, this is our setup and whatever they throw at us, it'll probably work. They're trying to guess what might TSM do? What do we know about them and how are they going to be playing? So that's pretty cool, and I mean, it seems to be working out. That is also, I would say, one of Pronax's strengths as a, you know, as a leader. And even if it's, and even if it was Flusher, which is not, but if it was Flusher calling, I'd still say, you know, Pronax should always give that input. So, you know, what might they be doing in this round? 25 seconds left here for a 3v4, and they got to win this round, TSM. I think if they lose this, it's starting to go downhill much too fast. So right now, Kerrigan just sneaking up. 15 seconds left, grenades raining on in. TSM trying to get onto the site here, and Kerrigan with a big opening, taking down Olafmeister, the heavy hitter. 10 seconds, 9 seconds, hit shot from Sipnix to take down Crimson. It's ticking out of time here, 4 seconds, and the bomb is going to go down. It's now Pronax and Flusher, and Pronax making his way out of bank here. This is a big round. Sipnix with another kill, taking down Pronax, and now Flusher all alone in a 1v3, and you can tell he knows this has slipped out of our hands. That was a very risky push from TSM, but they made it work perfectly. Very nicely done.
And Zipnix just seems so important in these rounds sometimes. You got to look at Kerrigan for how he opened that site. He walked in and just kind of cracked it open. But Zipnix, time and time again, is just delivering on these rounds for TSM. There's not many of them to speak of, but he's still doing some fine work for them over there. And well, as you said, this would have become almost too much of a spiral for TSM if they didn't get that round. So thank God they did. 8-4 is looking so dire, though. Just because you wouldn't say, oh yeah, well, Fnatic, they're weak on their T side, would you? It's going to be just as hard on the other way around. Fnatic, however, not well off for money at the moment. They've still got Flusher, of course, with that M4 in hand, P250, a CZ, but still, a dangerous team regardless.
Yeah, I mean, I think the silver lining here for the Danes has to be the fact that Fnatic are out of money, essentially. So if they can just get some good opening frags here, Cajun in charge of that, down in connector here, going to pick up the first kills. A couple more waiting around the corner, but he sprays and keeps holding it down for a triple kill. And pretty nicely handled. He made that look like that was the plan all along somehow. But this is obviously really important here. 8-5 is... like, they can salvage an 8-5 scoreline. If they get no more than 5 rounds, they definitely haven't lost the game yet. But I think if they get 8-7, then they can start to plan for an actual victory. And we'll see. Pronax and Flusher. Pronax hiding in the corner, but that USPS, Lauren, it's not just the weapon for the job, is it? Not when you're there.
Not quite, sadly. And Cajun going to get himself the 4K so far. Certainly another big factor. It seems like the Cajun B and Zipnik show at the moment. But still, Flusher, last man alive. Managed to stay alive last time. I don't know if he's going to have that success here, as already I think Cajun's starting to look for that delicious ace, and he will get it. What an incredible round to come out from as well. Something they vitally needed. It wasn't exactly the highest of investments from Fnatic, but they needed that fifth round regardless. Otherwise, as you said, spiral.
And that's actually Cajun catching up to Olaf, at least in kills right now. And the score is eerily similar. It's Cajun versus Olaf, and then everyone else is a good, you know, bit of distance behind there.
Yeah.
That's very interesting. And Fnatic actually feeling enough pressure in the 14th round here that they feel like they should go for a bit of a force-up. Plenty of grenades, which is good news, but still not the proper equipment, I would say.
And they've actually pushed up quite drastically. Olaf sticking out, the rest have backed off. That nade barely touching them. It looked like he had been so much closer, and we will see Fnatic starting to fall back.
Olaf has reached levels of confidence where he will actually jump and shoot with the M4 for no reason at all. I mean, did he expect to hit that shot? If he had hit it, we would have to report him right here on the stream. that's a ridiculous attempt, but yeah. Right now, TSM with a very, very careful round so far, and I mean, just the fact that Fnatic showed themselves early on out there means TSM have to spend so much time. That's one of the reasons why people should go aggressive right up there in the beginning. Even if they fall back immediately, it still serves a purpose. So good job there. I mean, look at the clock here, down to soon 45 seconds, and TSM are still only halfway across the map.
Well, how many plants have we seen coming in the last 10 seconds from TSM? They've all been fairly late in the game, and
Look at Fnatic. They actually think that because there's so little time left, it has to be a B push. That's what they're reading. Sipnik's going to be spraying through and almost takes down JW. Orlov is going to find a very nasty surprise around this corner. Sprays, but doesn't connect, and Device will take him out now. Crims has to go huge here. Otherwise, they might lose this round and the next one up as well, because they won't have money. This could be the turning point of the first half. After all the effort they put in, this could slip out of Fnatic's hands. Bomb is going to go down as well. Crims trying to fall back. JW takes down Device, and very important refrag. They only have one kit currently on Flusher, so he has to stay alive with that kit and get it close to the site. If it goes down farther back here, that's going to be a big issue.
And they're all in this area. None of them are pushing the back. They're all going to have to push from CT side. And here we go. Protax goes in. He does get the 1-for-1, but it's not good enough, leaving just Crims in a 1v2. TSM have the plant in their favor, but Crims comes in, gets down Dupree. Now Zipnix, 1v1. Fakes it out. He knows it's a fake. He's going to play this again, but Crims, he's going to make the push, but time is of the essence, and time is up. Nicely done by Zipnix then, and another highly important round for TSM.
Yeah, and Flusher did end up going down with that kit somewhere in the background, so Crims not only had to do a 1v2, but he had to kill one, find the kit, then kill the other one, then defuse. It's a very difficult task, and yeah, it does make a difference at the end of the day here. 8-6 moving into the 15th round, and Fnatic with a single FAMAS, 4 C-sets, 75s, and a lot of grenades. You know what? This is exactly the sort of round that Fnatic will win just because of the C-sets.
Well, they almost did it last time.
Yeah.
You know, these guys do this time and time again. You can't take it too lightly. And the thing that terrifies me is last time this worked, TSM went towards B and they got naded to hell. And well, then the CZ came out to play. So I'm seeing three players still over towards this B site. We've got JW, Olaf, and Crims pushed up quite aggressively in Cajun, just waiting out. This guy knows how they like to play, it seems.
Yeah, he's not even taking any shots to reveal that he has the AWP down there. He really wants to play this safe, but now it looks like, oh, they're going to come just as he escapes. And that, he hears the flashbang, so that should be a reminder that something could be going on here. If somehow Fnatic get this this flank in, and JW actually tracing the audio through the wall, which is why you sometimes see people looking into the walls, because if you look straight at people, it will tell you which way they're running, because you can hear if it's left or right in your headset. So before everyone starts going back in the chat, that's why it's there, guys. So, again, a round, as you were pointing out earlier, where the clock is running down. They like to execute late in the round, TSM, but now the flank is coming through, and this could be scary. JW, if he gets this kill from behind, even if it's just one kill, it'll slow down TSM a lot. They're pushing in, and JW is trying to run up from behind. He's making a lot of noise, and he hears it. He still gets the kill. Sipnik's 1 second further up, and he would have pretty got that. All of Meister going to be taken down. Kerrigan, the bomb is going down, but it's a 2v5 right now, and Fnatic are bringing him back in style. Cajun and Device are left, and now it's just Cajun, and he's got no shot at all. JW with a godlike flank. 3 kills, and the first one making it completely chaos for TSM. 9-6, and a good job here on the Swedish team in the final round of the first half.
Just Fnatic are incredible at those rounds.
Yeah.
Reading the situation, picking up so many vital kills. Unbelievable.
Now let's try and hear listening to TSM, just because I'm better at translating it, to see what they're going to do for the pistol round on the second half.
De har en... Oops. Der er kun flash smoke. De har en instant flash på B, hvis du ser dildoen, bliver du hvid. Og på højre side, get right.
Hvis du sidder, hvor ser du?
Hvad?
Hvis du sidder hvor?
Ja. På venstre side af dildoen, og hvis du sidder på højre side af getrap, bliver du hvid. Oh,
ja.
Der ligger nede på jorden.
Alright, colorful call-out spot names for TSM. But essentially just Kerrigan warning that they have a very particular pop flash down at the B-bomb site, and not to get caught off by that, essentially. Other than that, it looks like a standard setup for TSM, not really trying to, you know, do anything crazy. That's what we're seeing on the map as well. They don't have anything super special planned. They just don't want to get the pop flash. But Fnatic don't have any flashbangs. They've got a Glock train in the step, Pansy.
Hey, it might just work exactly the same. Who knows? They could just as achieve just as much. We'll have to wait and see. T-side taking their time, though. Bomb's still been almost left in T-spawn. They're not particularly hurrying. And, well, you can't really blame them at this sort of point. And, well, looking on the other side, it's a very cautious round from these two teams.
Yeah, it looks like Fnatic, on the other hand, might have been expecting TSM to come up with something adventurous, because they certainly did not want to get picked off at all. And that's okay. I mean, if you're doing this clock train thing, it's not such a bad idea to play it slowly, but once you get within a certain range of the bomb site, you want to keep going once you engage. You want to keep, you know, attacking. You can't slow down too much. So once the smoke clears, and it's going to be a little bit scary. They actually run back. They don't want to wait for the smoke. They're going to go back up towards the A bomb site, and there are no grenades left up there. So now TSM have got to hit some good headshots, and Device is the first one to make the call out that there's a lot of people coming, and the aim punch is there. Dupree's going to go down. Device pretty next in line here. Kerrigan trying to help out, and Cajun coming in with a really good double headshot, but it might not be enough here. The bomb, it's up on the box. No way! It's going to be now Sipnix in a 1v2, but they can't get the bomb with 10 seconds left. There it is. They finally pick it up, and now Sipnix, he does go for the shot there. Can't hit it mid-air. He's got 6 bullets left before he has to reload, and they make their escape there. All of Meister going to be around the corner. Sipnix trying to sneak on in. 3 bullets. He's still trying to fight Pronax here. He's out of bullets as well. Trying to reload right on top of him. Sipnix, is he going to get this kill? He won't. Pronax will take him out, and they both survive. One with 4 health, one with 2 health, and that's a huge round for Fnatic.
6 HP being the difference there. Unbelievable. And your heart kind of breaks a little for Sipnix in those situations, but you got to also argue that bomb going up on the box was just as almost unfortunate. But regardless, we did see Fnatic recovery, get the bomb down and kind of get back to the plan. But last time we saw these scouts paying off for Fnatic when they were on their CT side. Curious to see if TSM can do the same thing.
It must have been very, very, very close to the edge of the boxes.
To be able to jump up himself and pick it up,
yeah, because, but the thing is, there was a change to the game more than 6 months ago now, I think, where you actually had to sort of stand on things to get them up, because all previously you could very easily just jump and pick up things from a distance, but they changed it so you have to be a lot closer. Cajun with a good early scout shot there to take down Flusher, but that bomb on the box could have made the difference in this game right here, and it's kind of good for Fnatic that wasn't the case. JW, is he hearing the jumping? Kerrigan going to be falling back, and JW sees the opening. He actually runs around the corner while spraying, just trying to get that done.
TSM holding on here. They've got still all 5 players down, and Kerrigan's made it back alive somehow. He's down to 10 HP, but you can see Cajun B now going for a little bit of a look. Doesn't quite get what he wants, but Pronax is with the bomb. He's still up. He's still standing. He's on long. We're going to see the smokes coming out, and here we go. Fnatic start making the play towards the side, but Dupree finds Olaf with that CZ. JW right amongst the wolves. He's got 4 players around him, essentially. Pronax now has to kind of face the facts of it, and right now it's TSM just taking this over.
Yeah, 1v3 for Crims. He's got the 1 kill, but he's surrounded. He's got a Glock running for the smoke. And that's a definite no-no. Another round where Cajun makes all the difference. This guy's an absolute monster right now. If not for Cajun B, TSM pretty would have lost this match already. They would have been like, you know, 16-1 in favor of Fnatic right now. He's the main difference maker at the moment. It's a bit nuts to see him step it up this much.
One player can just change so much, you know, whether it was with the Deagle, whether it was with, you know, in that round, there's so many moments.
He's literally outfragging Olaf Meister in this game. 23 kills for Cajun, 20 for Olaf Meister. I can't believe it.
Brilliant to see. Such a player finding his form in such an important game. 10-7's the scoreline. Fnatic still in the lead, but as you can see, not a great deal of cash with them now.
But the thing is, Cajun creating so much space for his team means his teammates have to use that space. They have to get into the game, because there is going to be a round at one point where Cajun will go down as the first man, and then it can't just all rely on him. So TSM, they've got to do like a, you know, like a collective deep breath here and say, look, okay, now we have the space. Cajun has given us that. Now let's everyone get back in the game. It's our turn to shine as well. Oh, Sipnix there, great Molotov, really good timing on that one. And the follow-up, well, Cajun is stealing all the kills, but Sipnix really is doing a lot of damage as well, so I guess he deserves all the kills he can get at this point.
Yeah, and it's been really nicely dealt with by TSM. Just keeping them back, not losing anyone, keeping all weapons in play, and that's just exactly what they need at this point. Just keep building that economy up, keep getting that bank going, and well, Fnatic still aren't fantastic for cash. What, 3.5, 3K here and there? They're, you know, more than happy to work with it. But we're going to be seeing the CZs coming out, P250s, a Deagle there with Crims. It's really not ideal. So TSM's going to be almost at the doorstep of Fnatic score-wise. And I know how good TSM are on this CT side. It's something that we saw consistently throughout the online phase. But we, as we said, rarely got to see the T side. So let's see how good it really is. Now they've got a bigger challenge up against them. JW looking confident with that CZ.
Yeah, just JW things, right? Easy push up there. Dupree, a little bit too much out in the open for my taste. I'm not a big fan of this position. If they were multiple people peeking around the corner, then he could easily get caught. But now it's very clever. He's going to let them buy an easy double spray down. So thanks, Dupree, for making it look like I'm trying to badmouth you, but actually, that is a really bit tricky situation there. Flusher getting brutally disconnected, so we're just going to go for a quick pause here. Maybe we should listen in to TSM once again, just to see how, because I think the first buy round for Fnatic is going to come up, so maybe we can get a bit of a tune in here.
Prøv her, de havde samme go, som vi har på A. Smoke,
De kommer til at have problemer med det der, for han får ikke penge for runden, der var tabt, og de kan ikke gøre noget.
Sådan det jo. Ja, Smoke undergrunden igen så.
Er vi klar?
Vi er klar.
Alright, all of them ready, and actually what TSM are thinking here is that Fnatic will run a very similar execute towards the A-bomb site as to the one that they ran themselves, with the smoke towards bank and towards the stairwell going into the A-bomb site. So they're sort of trying to identify the attack method that might be going on the A-bomb site, no talk of B at all. And they weren't quite sure if they were going to have enough money on the Fnatic side to buy, because they thought one of the players disconnected, but we could tell that when he reconnected he had all the money. And a good bit of symmetry on that CT side here, 10 kills on everyone except Cajun.
It's kind of worrying. They've still stuck with, I think, we've still got a scout and device. We've got a Galil in there and a Famous.
Yeah.
It's going to be a little difficult, but I'm sure they've got a plan here to make it work somehow. But as you said, with the thoughts in mind, excuse me, A, seemingly the site they assume is being worked on. They've still got a nice aggressive play from device and Dupree pushing up on long, getting that control. But to be fair, you know, Fnatic are kind of going towards where they expect. You've got Flusher taking his time, but everyone else is slowly building up towards toilets, working their way towards A. Let's see if it actually works out.
Fairly forward push here from Cajun, and look at Dupree as well. This is the information plate that's coming out, and if he catches a kill, it's huge, but even if he just sees a couple of people, it'll be really big here.
Wait, Pronax is the bomb.
Oh. And that's huge. Yeah, he had the bomb. If he went down, then suddenly they had to go back and pick it up with 50 seconds left, and it would actually be a bit of a disaster. So Dupree, he sees the bomb, and that's worth a lot, but with 50 seconds, they can still change around, so this is going to be a hard round now for TSM.
I've just got to hope that they're, you know, still on the right place, still predicting the right site, and Device still sticking with the scout, but we still got Kerrigan there as well. He's backing him up, so Kerrigan's not too far away. Zipnix and Cajun B not in the right place at the right time, but Device has got a good glimpse here. He's getting that information, but you can see it's JW pushing forward just under where you can kind of see them, so maybe a little bit too far forward, but there we go. Device punishes him, sends him back, but now Fnatic surely have to commit. 14 seconds left.
Yeah, but they've got so little health. Crimson and Olafmeister have been tagged up with the scout, and Kerrigan is in a perfect position. This is straight for the bomb plant. He's going to spray and connect as well. Zipnix picking off the bomb plant. That's Pronex going down, and Crimson's the last man standing in a 1v3, and it's going to be 10-10. They tied the score on the TSM side, and look, that position that Kerrigan is in, a lot of teams now, I think the first team I saw really do it actively was probably Na'Vi, where they simply run in and spray that corner no matter what. They usually smoke it off, but even if it's smoked, they just run in and spray it, because they know that's the only spot on the site where you can stop the bomb from going down. It's the one place you can do it. So actually, Fnatic, I would say, slipping up, they should know that.
And to be fair, TSM have run that all the time online. That was something they've consistently done. That's why their A-hold was absolutely impenetrable. We're seeing this all-in play coming out from Fnatic, just piling bodies in towards B. It's just down to Olaf now. They only picked up Cajun. I don't know where the gun actually went down. I don't think Olaf can really retrieve it at this point, however.
Wow. Maybe that could have worked out. Fnatic looked like they almost had the timing, and I was a bit worried in the beginning Flusher might have got that headshot. But yeah, this is looking good. TSM about to take the round lead against Fnatic, and the Swedish team also don't have that much money, but they're definitely not out of this. This could still go either way, but I would say it is tilting a bit towards TSM's favor right now.
Considering the first half score, TSM's certainly really finding their footing on that CT side. And Olaf taking his time here and just kind of maybe thinking things through for the next couple of rounds coming up, thinking of what they're going to do and how TSM have been playing, and also just looking for a couple of kills on the way out here. So, really, I don't know what to make of this game. I still always feel that Fnatic have that next gear to go to. You can never quite write them out, but so far, TSM seem so solid. Dupree going to close it down, and we will see TSM taking the lead here.
I think Fnatic has, you know, they have more gears than anyone else, essentially. They always have a step, another level that they can go to right now, but it's really only Olafmeister is trying to reach that level, and somehow Cajun is finding a level that's even higher, which is nuts. 27 kills to 22 on Olafmeister, and everyone else on both teams is playing at a fairly similar level.
I was wondering if they were going to go that actually that aggressive again. They did it on that pistol, but when Kerrigan's doing this sort of work towards Olaf, you know that TSM's going to have the advantage. But here we go. Fnatic going to start making that play towards B. Great work coming out from Zipnix, though. But can he buy the time? Can he slow down the T players already? I think he's flushing with the bomb, pushed up on towards the site. I don't know if he's going to go for the bomb plant here. It'd be pretty cheeky if he does. But still, JW pretty far back. He's only got Crims with him on the site. But there we go. Bomb is down. But Dupree takes away Crims. And now JW is going to be asked a massive question. Same with Flusher, but these guys know how to deliver, and JW is, that's two already, bringing it back down to a 2v2. Flusher on the short side, but can he hold this using the smoke perfectly? Comes around the back, gets that one! Beautiful work from Fnatic to take control again, and those two players on that side just turned around. Such a difficult situation.
Yeah, that looked like it could have gone either way, and JW just being lethal in the background. We haven't seen too much from him in this game, but that was a high-impact round, really. And I mean, what's really crazy is that that round starts with both the two top fraggers going down. Olaf first and then Cajun next. And Cajun just simply got caught off guard, but he didn't expect the timing there. And the rest of Fnatic able to step it up, so really good job there. Sivnik spotting them, but the grenade is going to be a bit too early. And now we're at 11-11. Let's see how this game is going to unfold. This is going to be a very, very close game, it seems.
I'm absolutely loving this, though. You can't deny this sort of absolutely beautiful game of CS at the moment. And Fnatic going to have to start really operating on absolutely everything they have, with Cajun be hitting shots like that, finding Flusher as they were trying to make a play, and the bomb is loose as well. So already TSM going to get a nice advantage into this one, find their footing early, and just make Fnatic have to work even harder.
Yeah, those opening kills when you're on the CT side always feel very good, but it doesn't give them a lot of information, so they still have to play sort of very defensively here, and you can tell that they feel confident in doing that now. And Fnatic do have four smokes left, so they can definitely set up a good wall here and get the bomb down, but I think if you're a man down as you go into this site, keeping it, even if you do get the plant, is going to be very tough. And unless they can somehow get the kills on the guy holding in the sewer area that's right in front of the bomb site, if they can do that, where Sivnix is holding, if they can kill Sivnix, they get a lot of control. But if Sivnix is alive, this plant is going to be not that great.
Well, we're going to find out very soon. Zipnix is going to be the one, as you said, being such an important player in this one. The bomb is going down, actually, and these smokes completely blocking this off. And now it's going to be a massive retake. Five players still alive for TSM.
Wow, JW down here, going to make the flick, but not quite connecting. And Zipnix comes through with a good kill. Crims and Olafmeister, each with one in return. And Olaf with a double. JW is going to go down. It's down to a 2v2. Fnatic very low on health. And they do make their escape. Zipnix now, is he going to realize the bomb is in the middle of everything? He's got no grenades. He's going to try and fake it once, so now he knows they're both going to be on short. He fakes it one more time, but they're going to peek one at a time. Yeah, I don't think he has the time to even play like this. He's going to try and hold it in, and Crims is waiting. He's going to walk around the corner and get an instant headshot there. Very well played from Fnatic. They, because they had two players left, they could just peek that one at a time and always win that round. So very, very tricky stuff. TSM, I'm surprised they didn't win that round, but Fnatic did something very smart. They went for the plant that's very close to the monster entrance instead of trying to get the default plant in. I think if they tried to go for default, Sivnik's position would have been twice as effective. Instead, they actually kind of cancelled it by playing further back, so that was really smart by the Swedish team.
12-11, Fnatic just taking back the lead after TSM did start to claim it. Dove Ice not hitting the shot on long then. Gonna have to back up a little bit, readjust. But we know how good these guys are. And Kerrigan, if they start playing towards A, will push up to that, you know, infamous spot that we now know. He'll have such a powerful crossfire, but still.
And I think this is the round that TSM were trying to predict earlier, the sort of default attack around onto the A bomb site where you put down these smokes. This is what TSM thought Fnatic would do a lot more of, and they actually haven't been too predictable in that sense, Fnatic. So we'll see if TSM can counter it now that it's actually finally coming. And well, that kind of opening from JW, look at the Fnatic team. They want to go, and they want to go quick here. Device trying to see if he can find an opening, but it won't be easy. A lot of smoke's gone down. Maybe if he could pick off Pronax, who's coming in from that side, it would be a really big kill. He spots him out, but Pronax baits the shot and then goes for the kill. Olaf also going to take down Kerrigan, and this is looking great. Fnatic about to be ahead, not just a little bit, but a lot. They could almost close out the game now. TSM are going to be nearly out of money, and Cajun just trying to make his escape here. This is a huge impact round for Fnatic. They could bounce from 12 to 14 rounds without TSM being able to do much.
And they just denied so much of that A site. They didn't allow TSM to get in, and as soon as one player did, I think it was Kerrigan, who almost went down first on it. Cajun B's doing some fine work here, but it won't equate to much more. He's going to, you know, give himself some good bank and deny a lot from Fnatic. But regardless, Fnatic have got another round to play with, and if they can keep repeating this, TSM's kind of reign on A will just disintegrate. But Cajun, being closed in on by Olaf, and Olaf will find him in the end, but still, this is getting very, very close here.
Absolutely, and I'm sort of wondering what we're going to see from TSM. And they have the space to eco if they want to, but because they did so much damage at the end, it's not impossible that they could try and go for a little bit more. Doesn't seem like it's going to be armor, though. It seems like they're going to go for just a couple of pistols here. This is a very difficult spot here. The strat that the Fnatic just ran is really just meant to get the bomb down and then fight for the afterplant. But because they got the entry from JW, it was even more effective. So just a huge round coming up from the Swedish team. Really nicely executed, and TSM really didn't stand a chance.
Sadly not, and now they have less weaponry to work with, and just Fnatic looking like they know exactly what's up. Flush actually picking up the Mac Daddy there, going to look to do gain some bank. JW will find Device first and foremostly, and Kerrigan now just in a little bit of trouble in the spot of bother, but still, Fnatic taking their time, playing pretty cautiously, as you'd expect. But
it looked like maybe JW could have got shot in the back when he went into toilets there. I don't think whoever was on the stairwell heard him. And sometimes that's what it's like to play on LAN. You know, that's also why we make a distinction between LAN and online play, is that there is a lot of noise and people talking and fans and cameramen walking around. You can't always hear everything that you would if you were in the, you know, comfort of your own home here. Krims is going to get the kill on Dupree, and Kerrigan will finally take down JW, but obviously too late here. Cajun not going to get the reload in time. Civix will get an important shot. It's not quite done yet. This 5-7 is lethal, but Fnatic are going to group up to try and get him down, and that's a very smart idea. And Kerrigan should probably not try and fight for this, but he's going to do it anyway. He's getting one kill in. Grenade follow-up did a lot of damage, but he's not expecting Krims to be that close, and he's going to end up losing the round. Again, they did do a lot of damage, and the investment from TSM's point of view was sort of minimal. They only had pistols, and now they're going to be able to make the full buy, but now they also have to win it. Otherwise, they're out of the tournament.
Just, you know, to refresh your minds at home, in case somehow you weren't here for this entire event, I don't know where you guys were, but this is a best of one. This would mean that a team you'd argue are one of the best in the world goes out in the first stages of a tournament. That blows my mind, and it's horrific to see almost, but Fnatic bringing out the big game early here, taking it to 14 rounds against the 11 of TSM, and we're seeing Kerrigan and Dupree pushing up a little bit further, Device pushing up as well. Fnatic, clinical, cautious as ever. They play it just almost so stoically at times. They can just take their time, get control of the map, but no one's really holding long at the moment. Device is going to back out of this one, and Kerrigan and Dupree going to have to be a little careful because they're kind of stuck in no man's land. I think Flush is waiting on the other side, so this could be pretty damn costly here.
Oh, Flush, is he going to have the right timing right around the corner? Kerrigan is going to be there, and that's a big opening frag now. Quickly going to go around with a flank here, and Flusher will have seen that on the death cams. You can see Olaf Meister, and I think Kerrigan does this intentionally. He's trying to make them waste even more time, because he obviously knows about that death cam as well, so he's just going to try and see if he can fake it out a bit here. Dupree sneaking up into the kill on JW, and that's going to be another frag going in favor of TSM, and 30 seconds left in a 5v3. This should be TSM's round, spraying on through his Prodax, but he's not going to get the kill, and Cajun will reply swiftly. Krims and Olaf Meister, they can't do a lot, and they don't have a lot of money either.
Yeah, they're going to have to try and make a play. Olaf somehow finds Zipnix through that smoke. Fairly standard spot, you could argue, but here we go. Cajun B finds Olaf, and it's just Krims. 1v3, bombs not into hand, and with 13 seconds left, that is too much to ask, and TSM live to fight another day, it seems.
Yeah, and the really scary thing is, look, no bomb plant. If they'd had the bomb plant, they actually would have been able to buy here. That would have been the difference maker, and I'm absolutely 100% sure they would have bought if they'd got the bomb plant down. So now, instead, we could be seeing 14-13. They buy a little bit on the Fnatic side, a couple of grenades, which I'm a big fan of. I definitely think this is a good idea. And looks like they want to try and execute towards the B bomb site.
Yeah, we've got Olaf kind of working around. He's going to be met by Kerrigan and Dupree, I believe. They're in the same spot, and Cajun B, perfect. Flash comes out, it doesn't matter. JW just bulldozes in, takes him down, and actually, this B-side's fairly clear, excluding Zipnix. He's the only one close by. Bomb's going to go down, but Kerrigan pushes through at the perfect time, denies the plant, and makes this extraordinarily hard now for Fnatic. One by one, they should be picked up, but it's still JW and Pronax.
Yeah, one kill for Kerrigan, but it definitely was a high-impact kill. Otherwise, they'd be fighting against that bomb plant right now, and it'd be a very different scenario, so good stuff here for the Danish captain, and Pronax and JW really shouldn't be able to do a lot in a round like this. The bomb is down, and one of them has been spotted out here. TSM should set up a good situation, and they will. JW going down, so 13-14. Fnatic able to buy once again, obviously, And we're going to see if, I mean, this is as close as it gets. Whoever wins this round could very likely win the game.
14-13, Fnatic in the lead. But as you said, things can spiral off the back of these rounds, and this is one that will have so much impact going forwards. Device run the AWP. No AWP. I don't think it can even be afforded by Fnatic at this point. Yeah, a little strap for cash there, but still, let's see what they can bring out here. They don't always need that AWP to hand. JW can just do as he pleases with the rifles as well. And we're seeing Cajun B just taking Maz into his own hands, pushing straight to mid, picks up Pronax, and that's a massive pickup to begin.
Cajun has been just a terrifying force in this game. Sipnix has tried to step it up, and JW on the Fnatic team has done the same. So more people are catching on that we need everything we can get right now. We've got to go all in on this game here. And Cajun sprays and doesn't connect with Crims, does hardly any damage. So that's actually a bit of a shame there, because once you're in a 5v4, earlier, like they did, they could just try and play defensively and maybe even just win the round based off of it. But now they open the door for Fnatic to get back in the game. Dupree's going to hear them walking around the restrooms right behind him. And is he going to be able to walk out again? You can see JW remembers what happened last time. He's setting up for a smoke. Dupree, timing is going to be perfect. And Device taking down all of Meister as well. Flusher and Crims are left, and it's a 2v4. And Fnatic are feeling the pressure now, you can bet. Lauren, what do you think's going through their minds here?
I can't even imagine how much pressure is on these two players at the moment. One by one, they just got chiseled away at by TSM. It was just these kills coming from these beautiful angles. Dupree being pushed up, and as you said, Flusher, Crims, last two in this. Flusher does have the bomb. He's going to have the trouble. Dupree on long and make a device as well. They do pick up Flusher, and now it's Crims. 1v4, 10 seconds left. He doesn't have the bomb. It looks very much like TSM is going to bring this back to 14-14. And my God, I think we have an insane game on our hands.
This is everything you would have hoped for, right? I mean, again, just not to cry too much about it, but you wish this is the best of three at this point, because it's 100%. So close. Unreal. One of these teams is going to be out. It's 29 kills for all of Meister. It's 35 for Cajun B. What is going on? We're in regulation still. It's not overtime.
Look how much Fnatic have invested into this one as well. They're going all out here. They've got what, Tech 9, yeah. CZs, head armor. They've got the AK on Crims, but...
And TSM should see this coming. They should know enough about Fnatic's personality that they should see this coming. And again, a setup they've been running many times here. Device looking down towards the entrance to Long, while Dupree is covering the restrooms right behind him. Seems to have worked out fairly well for them so far here. But this is where it really starts to get serious for both the teams. They get the control. Moving in towards restrooms. Dupree is right here. And again, JW going to be walking in. He gets a headshot anyway on Dupree, and they know it. Call instantly made. He's stinked. Just move up, and Pronax will take him out. A very, very good trade coming in for Fnatic. They're going to do that every day if they can get away with it. And now they're setting up for the smokes like they did last time where they were interrupted. It's going to be a similar execute, but I'm wondering if they're going to commit to it. The bomb is still fairly far back here. They could try and fake it out. And in fact, no, they're sort of lingering right at the edge here. 35 seconds, so now they kind of have to go for it. It's not a lot of time for them to run back to B this time around. Flashes in, smokes in, and now we get serious. 28 seconds left. TSM, if they win this round, they knock Fnatic out of the tournament. Kerrigan in this corner again. They're going to check for it, but they don't have the weapons for it. He goes down eventually, and Pronax with the kill on Sipnix. It's going in that way anyway. 17 seconds, and Device with a very important kill on Pronax, but the bomb is down, and now they have to fight for the defuse here. Cajun is alive, and he has been the absolute raid boss at this point in time, and he's shown up. They've killed off all the adds now, and he's here to collect what's left. Cajun moving up with the M4 in hand, and he's going to be checking the corner. Sprays, but he's not going to get it. Crims will take him out, and now Device, almost no time left. He's running in for it, but he's going to get taken out by Olofmeister. And Fnatic now with a very good shot here. 15-14, and luckily for TSM, they have some money, but that's a huge round for the Swedish team. Very well played.
You just can't ever write Fnatic out. It doesn't matter what you give them, a CZ, a Deagle, it doesn't matter. They just seem to be able to make it work. And time again, they have. They're on match point, best of one. We're gonna have to see these guys go in massively. Thankfully, as you said, TSM can rebuy here, but this means everything. This is what it comes down to, and Cajun B, Zipnix, all of these guys will have to find that performance. They will have to meet the highest of echelons here, because Fnatic are operating on all cylinders now. And with 1 minute and 18 seconds left, this is a bit of a different start for Fnatic. They're looking actively towards B this time.
I want to see if, I mean, I wouldn't be surprised if they're going to try and walk JW into the site without any flashes or anything. Just try and see if he can walk in blind and get the surprise kill on someone inside here. Also, as our spectator was trying to point out there, Device and Dupree, who usually are the two people we really look for on TSM to get a lot of kills, are actually bottom fragging. So they are maybe bringing down the team just a little bit here. Cajun playing again, very much alone outside of the B bomb site. Are they going to see him? He's just hiding in this corner, and they are walking in. JW trying to look for an opening. 40 seconds left on Fnatic's clock here. They got to make a move. Smoke is up again, but they're going to try and inch their way through one more time here. 30 seconds, and now it's going to happen. Either they win, or we're going to see overtime. They're grouping up as a team while one guy is covering from behind, and that's Olofmeister. He's going to be making some noise over in Connector. A lot of Molotovs raining in. Sipnik's trying to push up close to the smoke, but he thinks about it and wants to go back instead. 18 seconds left. This is madness. Cajun going to go down, but Device gets a kill, and now it's going in favor of Fnatic. 10 seconds left for Device, and he can't stop the bomb from going down, and that's probably going to be the game. With that bomb plant down, almost nothing Device could have done. Fnatic, one kill away from knocking TSM out of the tournament, and it seems almost destined to be at this point. Device, he can't do a thing, trying to make it work, but what a game this was. Device trying to make it through. He's going to get a good shot in there and goes look for more, but he's going to go down to Olofmeister. And look at that joy.
That's a Fnatic who knew they had work to do, and they did it. But TSM took them all the way. And I've got to agree with you. If that was a best of three, I don't know which way it would have gone. But right now, Fnatic turned up. They did what was had to be done. But I don't think any of us could believe at the start of the day that TSM would be one of the teams going home.
No, I mean, almost no way to predict that. And, you know, it's decided by a best of one game on Overpass. That's a really, really rough loss. One that TSM will remember for quite a while. But I think both teams saw it coming, that this was going to be, you know, maybe not a coin flip, but it was going to be really tough either way. And it could have gone to either team.
And you've got to think how many rounds were salvaged from just insane play. Yeah. You look at TSM, the reason it got so close sometimes was Cajun B is just huge play, or Zipnik's going off on a tear. You look on the other side, every single player had beautiful moments. That force up that they brought out that just took them through. But still, enough from us, I think. We've had a bit of a treat here. Let's head over towards the analysis desk. Guys, take it away.
I mean, so much to be said and so little as well. Like, I mean,
what is going to make sense here?
Oh, good God. That. It's been said time and time again, and we can say it just one more time, that could have been such an incredible best of three, best of five. But we see one of, if not the best of one. That's how you described it just there, Devil Walk.
That was the most intense, like the best. I mean, there was so many amazing plays during that game.
Whew, recovery.
Like, that
I
was
lost my energy. I've
so
like, been
much
drained
good
by that
Counter-Strike.
Thing.
It was literally insane. It was the best one, like best of one I've seen. And I was really nervous as beep.
Yeah.
It's crazy, neither team wanting to give any ground. You saw all the different force buys, and so many. We saw Fnatic buy 5 CZs in like the fourth round of that first half. We see them at, you know, at, what was it, 13-14 or 14-14. They make that force buy happen with that 4-on-4 execute into the A bomb site.
Yeah.
Neither team wanting to give the other one an easy round, and they didn't throughout the whole thing. I mean, this is one time at the end of a day after 8 games where everyone's praying for an overtime.
Yeah, so I mean, it's exactly what it was. This is an example of what we're seeing from Fnatic. This wasn't the first nor the last, but this constant force buying, Natsu. Talk to me a bit about this.
Yeah, I think it's remarkable how well they can make it work time after time after time. I think the 29th round, as you pointed out, was probably that's going to be the definition of Fnatic and their ability of force buying and coming out on top of those rounds. Even though there are force buys and, you know, they're going to be in a way random, they're still so thought out. All the, like, how the timing works, how they're going to place their smokes and everything. So it's enjoyable to watch, and that makes for some phenomenal Counter-Strike.
I mean, yeah, the 29th round, but there was, like, so many, I mean, Sipnik's clutch, I mean, Cajun getting an ace, even, like, small moments, like Cajun picking up 3 guys when Fnatic almost won the round cleanly, made it so when Fnatic had them under control, when they had control over the game, TSM actually brought it back, and it seemed like they would actually take it. And then just that force by just bringing it back once again,
And not just force buys. Yeah. I mean, like, individual plays as well. Like, it felt like we were seeing... I remember us just sitting there and going, well, Olaf just saved them that round. Like, it was, every single individual, you saw Krims doing it there. It just seems like...
Well, how about that clutch in the first half from Zippix?
Yeah. That was insane.
That was insane.
Yeah. We talked about it. Yeah, Fnatic played it... like perfectly, and he still wins the round. Like you cannot say anything bad about how Fnatic played that round, and just so many individual performances that bailed each team out of crazy situations, and it happened round after round. It was just never once letting up with it.
Like only problem I have with this right now, how is anything gonna top that?
Yeah,
I mean, yeah, we've peaked, ladies and gentlemen.
It's the first day after all.
What a game, though. What I mean, that's one of those games I think the VOD is going to have a few viewing numbers. Because
I would imagine.
On the screen, you can see the pressure mounting and building throughout the match. It's just an amazing experience to watch.
Yeah. And I mean, you know, who else better to talk to than Olaf Meister himself? We're going to be bringing him in. It's time to say goodbye to Moses for day one as you magically disappear when we do take a look once again at those brackets and see how today has left us. 8 games were played and, good God, what a journey it has been. You do see Keedstars battling their way to the quarterfinals alongside Fnatic, who are going to be battling out with them tomorrow. That's going to be the first game of the day, and that's going to be another crazy game. Another journey for Fnatic will start then, and of course CLG waiting in the semis alongside Virtus Pro as well. I mean, that's just been by no stretch of the imagination could you ever look at those four groups and predict those results.
Yep.
Olaf. I've just invaded the desk. First of all, big congratulations. The first thing we said when we saw that when that 16th round came in was that was the best of one to as a spectator. I'm sure you felt very differently about that one. That must have been like so much pressure so early on in a tournament.
Yeah, I want to point out one thing though. This is the biggest tournament to date. Shouldn't be one best of one. I just want to like TSM shouldn't go out in the groups like that. It's if I were in their shoes, I would be. I don't know how I would feel, man. Yeah. I don't think it's fair, but
It's the kind of general consensus. I mean, this only happened because so many low probability teams won, and it kind of this created.
Yeah,
this,
but this it can strike like everybody can beat everybody no best of one, so it's.
Yeah, so I mean, moving away from that and more into kind of how this game shaped up for you, as an individual, you turned up, but also as a team. I mean, that must have been against TSM as well. Was that a game that you went into aiming for Overpass?
Well, we have other maps that we would like to play that they banned, but we kind of figured it will be Overpass. Mm. So we actually looked through some things before the game, and we kind of like small things that helped us a lot. But yeah, we kind of knew that it will be Overpass.
Mm. Natu, you got a question?
I'm still rattled about this match. I don't know.
I could ask a question. I mean, going through a very, very tough loss early on, how does one like group up? Kind of, what do you say to each other after a loss like that? What keeps you motivated for the next match and like kind of positive?
Well, we talked over the game against CLG and we kind of all agreed that we didn't talk that good. Not like we talked bad or negatively, but we didn't talk good. Like we like died and nothing happened. So, and we also were a lot more pushing each other this game. And I think if you compare the first POV and to this POV, it's a big, big difference.
Yeah, night and day.
But
probably.
CLG, they like they played really good. They were the better team. There no denying that.
And so that's good to hear. So you, I mean, you've played against CLG beforehand. Was it like a completely different team that you felt like you went up against, or were there still those same kind of weaknesses there?
I wouldn't say they were like completely new. They was like, we know what to do if we meet them again.
Right.
I promise you that.
Okay, already a sign of things to come for Olaf then. Any closing thoughts from you guys?
Just awaiting what more amazing Counter-Strike.
Can I go? Can I do the passion?
Yeah. Can you do the passion? He knows what he's doing.
No, you cannot.
Yeah, don't
all
do
the passion. Can do this.
Don't do the devil walk where it's like, yeah, go. Oh, that's fine. Yeah. <See you later.
laughs> I thought production would like be with
okay. Yeah, I don't think we watched it back and we just saw the big like thumbs up from devil walk. Like, yeah, it's fine.
I did create a good video though.
It did.
I mean, so finally, just a big congratulations. We'll continue to see you in the tournament. Commiserations to TSM. It's a crazy tale that's led them to this elimination, and it's something that nobody ever would have predicted. And I mean, at the least we have that. That is a surprise and a big commiserations to them. That is kind of it for us then. 8 games is what we managed to dig our teeth in today. And we're going to be bringing you so much more in day 2 in this 4-day event. From everyone here who has been at the desk, goodbye. And also from everyone behind the scenes, we'll see you tomorrow.